if you close the vents halfway, it'll lower the temperature. That way you don't accidentally scorch the chicken. You can always open the vents and the temperature will rise because there's more oxygen inside the chamber. But if you're new to it, go ahead and close the vents. That way you can manage your temperature a little bit better. Now I had to do this out of necessity. What you got here is you got basically, I guess, a third of a stick of butter. We're gonna baste the chicken with that. It helps with crisping the skin. Almost really fries the skin. And then we'll put melted butter on the beer can chicken. You got yourself a winner with that.
Take this and just dump right in there.
Oh man, that looks good already. The color is beautiful.
Do that. Set that bad boy down. Scene 15.
So we've got the butter successfully melted. Slowly. Very important. Slowly. So we're going to go ahead, move this off to the side. Not bad color. You don't want too much color up front. Again, remember the chicken's back is towards the fire. Oh man, the mesquite, just enough mesquite. I know, Ed, I know you can smell that mesquite.
Yes, sir.
That's right. You better take notes too.
Okay. How's that looking?
Oh my goodness, that is awesome.
Yeah, it's just into it a little bit, but it's gonna get rolling. You got that thyme, that rosemary, that white wine. It's gonna be magnificent.
Time to baste the chicken with the melted butter. We're about 20 minutes in. Our target time is about 100, listen to me, about an hour and 15 minutes. And I'm just gonna baste it on. Now the first basting, you need to be a bit gentle because the rub might not have set in, especially if you put it on the way I did. I didn't actually rub it in. I just kind of put it on the side. I'm really glad we're using C-Dub's barbecue rub. What that's gonna do is add that pop, add that extra kick. You know you want to have that pop, especially with the heat that Ed Hamlin is bringing from Grill Innovations. You got to have that pop, man. Otherwise, you're going to be left in the dust, and we can't have that.
Or you're going down.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. Don't you worry about that.
Going down. Key lime pie is ready. I hope you're hungry.
Let's see it.
There it goes. Booyah.
Oh, beautiful.
How's that look?
Beautiful.
Slide it out of here.
It's been about 33 minutes since we put the chicken, the beer can chicken, on the grill. Let's check it out. Very cool. Doing a second basting with our magic butter. The C-Dub's barbecue rub, giving this thing a nice color. That rub is red inside the bottle. It's gonna make the chicken a bit red, and we don't mind because it is on the grill. But inside, it is nowhere near being done. Ed, true or not true, you always wanna overcook it before you undercook it.
Absolutely.
You serve your guests undercooked chicken, they're not coming back. Very, very bad, okay? It's gotta be cooked through. As you can see, we got a third member to the wrecking crew here. This here is Charles Maddox, also known as the Poor Chef. Charles, man, we're glad to have you out.
I'm flattered to be out here. I'm actually, today I'm gonna gain a little bit of weight. I didn't come to eat a thing, but Ed is an unbelievable chef.
Ed was actually telling me a tip here about the thermometer and setting in the egg. Go ahead, tell him what you told me.
He was gonna take his little digital thermometer and stick it in the bird, but it's plastic, so he's gotta pull it back out. Well, I said, let's do this. I got another thermometer for you. We're gonna stick the thermometer and then you leave it in there and then that chicken's gonna stay nice and moist. Yeah. As soon as you pull it out, it's gonna all run out.
Look at Ed, taking me to school. My own show, taking me to school. So Ed, what's target temp we're looking for?
I thought you always just pull a piece off Ed and just take a bite.
We were gonna do that. There's two schools here. Some people say 165 and let it run up. Some people say 180, breast temperature at 180.
Yeah.
Now you gotta remember, whatever temperature you pull off, it's gonna gain 5 degrees.
Yeah.
So my target temperature on this would be probably about 170, 175.
Okay.
And it'll hit that 180 as it's resting. You want it to rest, because as soon as you cut, all that juice is gonna come flowing out of it.
Yeah.
And
So is it ready now, Ed?
Now,
It's not ready now?
No, no, but I got some cookies for you.
I had a couple of cookies.
Oh, man.
And I've had the bread. But I want to get to the meat and the potatoes.
It's going to be just a couple more minutes.
You kidding me? Now that's going to be some good eating. That right there is some good side dish.